Welcome, dear children, once again for the English class. In today's class, we are going to learn one more new topic in grammar. In my previous class, I have taught you about grammar. In grammar, we have learned nouns, gender. So before going to today's topic, I'll be revising you some things about my previous class. So what is the meaning of gender? Gender means categorizing the noun form, whether it is a male or a female. You have learnt about what is the meaning of gender, first one. Gender means categorizing the noun into male and female. Secondly, I have learnt about types of gender. In these types of gender, you have learnt four things. That is masculine gender, feminine gender, common gender, fourth one is neuter gender. So how many types of genders are there, children? There are four types of gender. They are masculine gender, feminine gender, common gender and neuter gender. So let's revise once again about each one of the gender one by one. So first one is masculine gender. A noun that stands for a male living being is said to be of the masculine gender. So what is masculine gender, children? A noun that stands for a male living being is said to be of the masculine gender. Example, father, brother, uncle, etc. So this was about masculine gender, what I have taught you about in my previous class. Just I am revising. You can have the glance on the board. See what I have written and read it, children, in the mind. A noun that stands for a male living being is said to be of the masculine gender. Example, father, brother, uncle, etc. Now we will go to the next one, that is feminine gender. Second one is feminine gender. Feminine gender. Now let us see the definition of feminine gender. A noun that stands for a female. Masculine was male. Now it is female living being. Female living being. Is said to be of the feminine gender. Feminine gender. Example, mother, sister, aunt, etc. So this you have learnt in my previous class, so children. Once again I am revising. Read the definition. Feminine gender, a noun that stands for a female living being, is said to be of the feminine gender. Example, mother, sister, aunt, etc. Now, let us see the third one. The third one is common gender. Common gender. A noun that denotes both a male and female. Is said to be of the common gender. Common gender. Example, doctor, teacher, cousin, cousin. So third one is common gender, a noun that denotes both male and female. For example, I have given you doctor. The doctor may be female doctor or a male doctor. So such type of nouns are called as common gender. A noun that denotes both male and female is said to be of the common gender. Example, doctor, teacher, cousin. Fourth one, that is neuter gender. Neuter gender. A noun that stands for non-living things is said to be of the neuter gender. Neuter gender. So that means we, all the non-living things. Non-living things are called as neuter gender. It comes under neuter gender. Example, pen, bag, bat, knife, etc. So you can observe, children, these examples are all non-living things. Pen is a non-living thing, bag is a non-living thing, bat, knife, these are all non-living things. The noun that denotes or that stands for non-living things is said to be of the neuter gender. That's all it was about the nouns and the genders, children. I hope you all understood. Once again I have revised it. So answer the questions. If you have any doubts, you can ask your parents. Now today we'll go to the new topic. We are going to learn one more new topic in grammar. So you are going to learn today one more new topic about nouns only. Nouns, numbers. In nouns, number. So many times when we talk, when we write the nouns in the form of numbers. So sometimes we talk about one person or one thing. Or place. Or animal. So when it is one person, such type of nouns are counted in singular form. Singular form. That is singular form of noun. It is called singular or singular form. So when we talk about one person, thing or place or animal, so such type of nouns are called singular nouns. So today we are going to learn about singular nouns and plural nouns. When we talk of many person means more than one. Not one, it is more than one person, place, thing or animal. So such type of nouns are called plural nouns. Plural nouns. Plural nouns. So today your topic is about singular and plural. So let us see this one by one. Children, I'll be writing some words. You read these words. Kids, trees, children, park, football, girl. So when you read these words, you can see the difference here. Kids, trees, children. So these words are showing the noun which are more than one. More than one. Such type of nouns are called plural nouns. Now here you can see park, football, girl. These words are denoting only one. Only one. So such type of nouns are called singular noun. Singular noun. So children, once again I'll be telling you, listen. Kids, trees, children. You can see here it is denoting the plural form. So it is more than one. So it is called as plural nouns. Park, football, girl, they are only one, that is in the singular form, so it is called singular noun. You all are always reading the singulars and plurals from right from the first standard itself, no, right children? Now we'll see the definition of singular and the definition of plural. What is the meaning of singular? Only you know, you always miss will write singular, plural. So the definition of singular nouns, we'll see definition of singular nouns. Nouns means name. Noun is the name of a person, place, animal or a thing. So nouns which stands for one person, place, animal or thing are called singular noun. Singular nouns. So children, listen once again. Till now you were only reading the words. Miss used to give the words in the singular form. You used to write the words in the plural form. Now you have to understand what is the singular nouns. To understand the singular nouns, you need to know the definition. So the definition of singular noun is, or the what is noun. Sometimes we ask you question, define singular noun with example, or write what is a singular noun. Give examples like that. Question will be given. You have to write the answer. This one, nouns which stands for one person, place, animal or thing are called singular nouns. Example. Goat, wife, balloon, park, etc. So children, the examples are goat. Goat is an animal. Wife is a person. Balloon is a thing. Park is a place. So the nouns which stands for one person. So one goat is called only goat. So if many goat are there, that time you read as goats. Wife, wives. Balloon, balloons. Park, parks. So these are the singular form. Goat, wife, balloon, park. So once again I'll read the definition for you all. Nouns which stands for one person, place, animal or thing are called singular nouns. Example, goat, wife, balloon, park, etc. So that was about singular noun. Now we'll see second one, that is plural noun. Plural nouns. So the definition of plural nouns are nouns which stands for more than one person, place, animal or thing are called plural nouns. Plural nouns. Example: sarees, women, donkeys, chairs. So children, the definition of plural noun, nouns are nouns which stand for more than one person, place, animal or thing are called plural nouns. Example: sarees. Sarees means many sarees, not one saree. It may be two or three or four. Women. So more than two women, one woman. Donkeys. More than one donkey. Chairs. More than one chair. So such type of word nouns are called as plural nouns. Now let us see how these plural nouns are formed in different ways. We know about the singulars. So now we learn how these plural nouns are formed. We add s to most of the singular nouns to make the plural. Now we'll learn how to make the singular to the plural nouns. Okay. Now let us see how we'll change the singular. Nouns, singular nouns. So I'll be teaching you how we will change this singular to the plural nouns. Most of the time, children, we add s to all the singular forms. For example, chair. To write the plural form of chair is chairs. So most of the time we are adding s. For one more example, boy, boys. See, the when we add boy s, it will be the plural form. So most of the time we are adding s to make the plural form, but always we cannot add. There are some rules for making this plural forms. Let us see. Commonly is you add s, but different ways are there to form the plural forms. Let us learn that. This is the most common one which we write always. Now I said to you the first rules, that is first one is we add most of the time we add s, right, to the singular form, singular noun. So this is one way we make the plural form. Second one is, so when the noun end in s, x, sh or ch. So see children, listen carefully. Nouns which end in s, x, sh, ch, we need to add, we form plural by adding adding es. So first one was we added only es. Now second way is when the word that when the noun ends with s, x, sh, ch. I'll be telling you some examples, children. Listen carefully, okay? For example, box. So box is ending with x. So second rule is what? When the noun ends with x, we need to add es. So to form plural form, boxes. Then s, glass. Observe the words, children. So it is ending with s. So glasses. So we are adding es. Here also I added es to form the plural form. Now dish, d I s h. So word is ending with s h c, children. That's third one is. First one is over. Second one is over. Now the noun which ends with es h. Dishes, d I s h e s, dishes. Here we are adding es. Then the fourth one or ch, when it ends with ch, for example churches, church, churches. So it is ending with ch. Here we have need to add es. So second rules is when the nouns end in x, x, sh and ch, we form plural by adding es. I have given you the examples, children. Here you can see box. This noun is ending with x. So when we form the plural form, we write boxes. Boxes. Glass, glass. So it is ending with s. So plural form is glasses. Glasses. Then dishes, dish. It is ending with sh. So we add dishes. Dishes. Churches. Church. Church. So it ends with ch. We add es. Churches. So this is one way to form the plural form. So first one was only by adding s. Second one is we add es when the noun ends with s, x, sh and ch. Now third way we'll see. Third one, when the noun end in y, end in y, and there is a consonant before y, see here rules, and there is a consonant. I already explained you what are the consonants and vowels, right? So the word noun which ends with y and there is a consonant before y. Where? Before y. We drop y. We drop y. That means we remove y and add IES. See, third rules is IES. So only when we write some of the plurals, you can see the ending letters, that is IES. So the third rule, children, is when the nouns end in Y and the condition is there. There is one condition. What is the condition? And there is a consonant before Y. So some nouns are there which will end with Y, but it has consonant before Y. That time we should drop. Drop means we should cancel that Y and use IES. I'll be giving you some example. Party. See, this noun is ending with y and there is a consonant. So it is ending with y and it is having a consonant. So that time you need to drop y. So part, we have to cancel y and use ie. Is the rule is telling us before y if there is a consonant, we drop means we cancel and add ies. So party. So plural form of party is parties. See, I have dropped the y, that means I have not written the y or cancelled y and used ies. One more example I'll give you. Story. So it is ending with y and there is a consonant. R is a consonant. So when we write the plural form, it will be stories. See, I am using ies. So this is about the plural form, third rule. That is, when the nouns end in y and there is a consonant before y, we drop y and add ies. So first rule was we add s usually to form the plural form. Second one was when the noun ends with s, x, sh or ch, we form plural by adding es. So first one was only s, second one was es. Third one, when the nouns end in y and there is a consonant, we use ies by dropping y. So these were the three rules you have learned. Now fourth one we'll see. So when nouns end in y, see, don't get confused, children. Third one also was end in y, but there is a change. What is that change? And there is a vowel before y, we add s. So children, don't get confused, because third one I told when the nouns end in y, but I told you one point there, and there is a consonant before y, and there is a consonant before y. That time we are using ies. Don't tell our mister to use s, so I am using s. When to use s, you see here, when the nouns end in y and there is a vowel before y. So previous one was consonant before y, now it is vowel before y, we add s to form the plural form. Example, day. See, y is there, a is there, a is a consonant, sorry, oval. So we add s, only s. So there is a rule, not simply we'll add s. Then boy, boys. See here, o is a oval, a is a oval. Now next, key. E is a oval. Keys. Valley. Valleys. So you can see, children, here when the noun is ending with y and there is a vowel before y, that time we are using s. You can see here, it we are not cancelling y here. In the previous example I told you y is cancelled, ies is added. Here no cancelling y. Y should be kept as it is. Okay, only when there is a consonant before y, that time you should cancel y and use ies. Now next one is most of the nouns end in f. So fifth one, most of the nouns end with f and in f or fe. See what to do, you see children, when the nouns are ending with in f and fe, we form the plural by changing. See what we have to change? Changing f or fe into V-E-S. So keep in your mind, children, when to write V-E-S. Most of the time you get confused, no? Oh, miss told to use S, so use only S. No, when we have to use S, you see, there are the rules. Follow those rules. When the nouns end in F or F-E, we form the plural form. Plural by changing. What we have to change? F or FE. We change F or FE into VES. Example. Calf. CLAVES. So we are changing this F to into what? VES. Keep in your mind, children. So when it is ending with F, we change it to VES. Wife. So it is ending with FE. See, I told you in end in F or FE. So when it is ending with F or FE, we change F or FE into VES. WIWIVES. So children, you understood the fifth rules, no? Fifth rule, that is most of the nouns end in F or FE. We form the plural by changing F or FE into VES. Example, calf, C-A-L-F. So, when we write the plural form, it is C-L-A-V-E-S, calves. Wife, W-I-F-E, wife. W-I-V-E-S, wives. That was the word V-E-S. Now we'll see the sixth one. What is the way how we write the plural form? How some nouns do not follow these rules. Some nouns, they don't follow the rules. Example, that is when it ends with F. I told you when it ends with F, it will not follow the rules. Some words are there. For example, roof. So it is ending with F, don't change it to VES. So there is no rules for applied for such type of a words. Roofs. Proof. So children, however, some nouns don't follow this rule. Which rule? That is when it ends with F, in F and FE, we are asking you to change it to VES. That time, some nouns are there, we should not apply this rule here. It don't follow the rule. That is P-R-O-O-F, proof. P-R-O-O-F, proofs. So children, this was about the singulars and plural, how to form. I have told you about the 3, 5, 6 rules. So sometimes it will not apply the rules here. This is an end one. So first, only by adding s. Second one, by adding es, when the nouns end with s, ends with s, x, ch, sh. So that time we use es. So when the noun ends with y with a consonant before it, that time we are using ies. Sometimes it ends with nouns with ends with y, but vowel before y is, we use s. And I told you about the nouns which ends with f or fe, we use ves. And one more, that is some nouns will not follow this rule. When it ends with f and e, fe, we add just s. So rules is not applied here. Some nouns are there, for example roofs, proofs and many more. So children, this was all about nouns number. Still some more different ways are there to follow the rules to form the plural form. So tomorrow I'll be explain some more rules about the plurals. So that's all for today's class, children. Remaining I'll be explaining you in my next class. Till then, children, revise this lesson by watching the video and try to understand it and observe the examples. Okay, till then, bye bye, children.